We have breaking news on a sad note. The mother of Hillary Rodham Clinton has died. We were given an indication earlier today that that her health was not good. Dorothy Rodham, born in June of 1919, when Hillary Clinton canceled a trip overseas at the last moment. She died shortly after midnight, this on the 1st of November, 2011, in Washington, D.C., and she was surrounded by family at the time. And our thoughts go out to the Clinton family today, and the Rodhams as well, for this news and the passing.
Hillary Clinton's mother, Dorothy Rodham, has died. The Clinton Foundation says that Mrs. Rodham died early today in Washington. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton had canceled an overseas trip because her mother was sick. Mrs. Rodham occasionally appeared with Clinton on the campaign trail during her 2008 presidential run. Dorothy Rodham was 92 years old.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has lost her mother. Dorothy Howell Rodham died in Washington, D.C. early this morning at the age of 92. There is no word on the cause of her death. Clinton had canceled a scheduled trip to Britain and Turkey this week so that she could be with her mother in her final hours.
The mother of Secretary of State Hillary Clinton passed away at the age of 92. Dorothy Howell Rodham died early this morning in Washington. The family statement described her, and I'm quoting, as a warm, generous, and strong woman, an intellectual, a woman who told a great joke and always got the joke, an extraordinary friend, and most of all, a loving wife, mother, and grandmother.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton mourning the death of her mother today, Dorothy Rodham. The Clinton family says Mrs. Rodham died surrounded by her loved ones shortly after midnight at the age of 92. Mrs. Rodham's funeral will be private.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's mother, Dorothy Rodham, died today. She was 92.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's mother, Dorothy Rodham, died today, shortly after before midnight in D.C. Excuse me, we're told Secretary Clinton was scheduled to be overseas, but that she'd already canceled that trip so that she could be at her mom's side. Dorothy Rodham was born in Chicago, the daughter of a city firefighter. She mostly avoided the spotlight during her daughter's years as the First Lady and then as the Senator from New York and beyond, but she turned up on the campaign trail during Secretary Clinton's 2008 presidential bid, and she was a bit of a hit. She was also there when her daughter conceded the nomination to then-Senator Barack Obama, and later when she became the Secretary of State. The family says it plans to hold a private ceremony in her honor. Dorothy Rodham, dead today at 92 years old. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's mother died overnight at a hospital in Washington, D.C. Dorothy Rodham was a homemaker for much of her life. Her parents reportedly abandoned her during a bitter divorce when she was but 8 years old. And she and her younger sister took a train cross-country to live with their grandparents. Dorothy Rodham stayed out of the spotlight as her daughter rose from lawyer to first lady. But she was at her side when then-Senator Clinton campaigned for the presidency back in 08. Her family released a statement saying, "She overcame abandonment and hardship as a young girl to become the remarkable woman she was." Dorothy Rodham, dead today at 92.
And now a sad note today. She was seemingly an ordinary mom, but she was anything but ordinary. Her daughter, Hillary Clinton, wrote in her autobiography, Living History, "I'm still amazed at how my mother emerged from her lonely early life as such an affectionate and level-headed woman. She was warm and approachable even while living in the White House and on the campaign trail." What's so extraordinary is that Dorothy Rodham had a simply dreadful childhood. She was sent away from home at the age of 8, making a cross-country trip together with a younger sister to live with unwelcoming grandparents. It's a tale right out of Charles Dickens, Transplanted to the Great Plains. But she survived, and she helped instill her independence and her questing spirit in her daughter. Our thoughts today, our prayers, are with the Clinton family at the loss of their mother, their grandmother, and mother-in-law.
What could have been, what would have been if Clinton were president? Well, if new polls are any indication, the Democrats would be in much better shape heading into 2012. Dorothy Rodham encouraged Hillary's passion for learning.
She had a very high value on education. And I'm not talking about possessing a degree. I mean, she put a premium on learning.
What I would like people to know about Hillary is what a good person she is. She never was envious of anybody. She was like a lot of other little girls, except that Hillary was kind of a leader. I mean, the other kids liked to do the things that she wanted to do, and she could do it very well as far as directing them. And she had a lot of she was kind of mature very little girl. She was helpful, and she's continued that with her adult life. She's been very active with social justice causes. She has empathy for other people's unfortunate circumstances. I've always admired that because that isn't always true of people. You know, there's a dichotomy here. I'm her mother, and I know from experience and from watching and observing that it's a very, very difficult, strenuous job and life to be President of the United States. And I know that she has all of that to do the job. That's as her mother. But I'm another person, I'm a citizen. And I think that she ought to be elected because she's the best qualified. I would vote for Hillary, even if she weren't my daughter.
Dorothy Rodham dreams of a brilliant career for her firstborn.
She took subversive pleasure in teaching Hillary how to fight with the boys.
I'm so glad to be here.
I didn't know until just later this afternoon that all three generations was going to be here. Oh, it was wonderful. I think Chelsea is a lovely young lady, just beautiful.
I came to see the Rockettes.
Yes, we can. She's got family members around her helping her.
I think it's a very good thing that she can bring her family and share her experiences and her things with her family.
I was so excited to see Chelsea and her mother because I had heard a rumor that her mother would be here tonight. I had no idea Chelsea was going to be here tonight, and so I'm really excited to have them here.
Great, honey. First time having daughters of my own and having a mother I took care of for many years, I think it shows that she's a compassionate person, a loving mother and daughter.
And I'm so pleased today to have two people with me who mean the world to me. So I'm thrilled that I have my mother and my daughter with me tonight. My mother, Dorothy Rodham, my daughter, Chelsea Clinton. And I'm running for president because I want to make multi-generational change. You know, our children need a good start in life. They need strong families. And then we need change for everybody who's working. Everybody who's making a living and feeling like, you know, it's not possible to get ahead the way we used to in America. And then, of course, for our seniors, for our parents and our grandparents, we have to protect Social Security. We have to protect Medicare and make it work right. So when I think about running for president, I think about what I want to do with your help to be a president for everybody. You know, the rich and the powerful, they've had a president for 7 years, haven't they?
You know, I have
ever since I've been a little girl, felt the presence of God in my life. And it's been a gift of grace that has, for me, been incredibly sustaining. But really, ever since I was a child, I have felt the enveloping support and love of God, and I have had the experiences on many, many occasions where I felt like the Holy Spirit was there with me as I made a journey.
And after so many decades, 88 years ago on this very day, the 19th Amendment, giving women the right to vote, became enshrined in our Constitution. My mother was born before women could vote. My daughter got to vote for her mother for president. This is the story of America, of women and men who defy the odds and never give up.
Now, on a personal note, when I was asked what it means to be a woman running for president, I always gave the same answer, that I was proud to be running as a woman, but I was running because I thought I'd be the best president. But I am a woman, and like millions of women, I know there are still barriers and biases out there, often unconscious, and I want to build an America that respects and embraces the potential of every last one of us. I ran as a daughter who benefited from opportunities my mother never dreamed of. I ran as a mother who worries about my daughter's future and a mother who wants to leave all children brighter tomorrows. To build that future I see, we must make sure that women and men alike understand the struggles of their grandmothers and their mothers, and that women enjoy equal opportunities, equal pay, and equal respect. Let us resolve and work toward achieving some very simple propositions. There are no acceptable limits, and there are no acceptable prejudices in the 21st century in our country. You can be so proud that from now on, it will be unremarkable for a woman to win primary state victory. Unremarkable to have a woman in a close race to be our nominee. Unremarkable to think that a woman can be the president of the United States. And that is truly remarkable, my friend.
HillaryClinton.com.